Alright, so today I'm gonna play the greatest Mega Man game I ever made of all Mega Mans. Mega Man 3. And right off the bat, you could see that unlike the other Mega Mans, this Mega Man says, you were expecting a cutscene or a menu at the beginning? No, fuck that. We're gonna jump right into the start screen, and you're gonna play the game. We're gonna skip the foreplay and get right to the action. And I kinda like that incentive. And then the other games were gonna do that, and maybe they were just, they were too stressed out in building this game. They were like, we don't have time to build a cutscene, or they couldn't think of anything, because there's a lot of backstory to this game that is not explained at all. You wouldn't even know it unless you looked it up on the internet or something. But no, they couldn't put in a cutscene. That'd be too easy. Here's Top Man. Looks like he's wearing cowboy boots. At least it always did to me, because the little heels pop out of pixels. Which is what makes him spin. If I was Top Man, I mean, like all these robots so far until this game, they were, they kind of had a sense of practicality to them. You could understand where they'd exist in the real world as a practical robot. Because really, that's what all these robots were built for. They weren't just built for no apparent reason. They were built to help humans. So, you could understand where, you know, all the original six robots came from. Because they were built by Dr. Light. And he only built robots to, you know, take jobs from people. And then Dr. Wily came in, and he stole them, and then he built his own robots, which were to take over the world, but, like, they still had a little bit of practicality and, you know, traditional element to them. You know, they're pretty much just like remakes of the original Mega Man 1 bosses, because, like, you had, Fireman was turned into Heat Man and all these things. So Wily had a bunch of robots and they kind of made sense. But then Mega Man 3, supposedly the story is that, like, Wily didn't build these, like, these robots just came, like, fabricated out of thin air or something. I don't know where they came from. They just decided to go crazy and take away the elements that they were using for Dr. Light and Dr. Wily were joining forces to build a peacekeeping robot called Gamma, which at first didn't make any fucking sense, because you played this game, you didn't know that there was a story to it. You get to, there's a cutscene later, and he's like, oh no, Wily stole Gamma, what are we gonna do? And I'm like, well, what the fuck is Gamma? What are you talking about? I mean, I know I have to stop Wily because he's the bad guy. And, but no, apparently there's a story that he was good and he trusted him for some stupid reason. And now he betrayed him and he's shocked, and now I have to clean up his fucking mess. So, that's what happened. Now I'm gonna get to the boss, which, by the way, Top Man seems like, if I was Top Man, I would have some severe self-confidence issues. Because who fucking builds a humanoid top robot? And for what purpose? I mean, he's not even good at self-defense. Look at him. His only attack is to throw his cranium at me or to spin around like an angry drunk. So I have to get that compensated by calling him Top Man, so at least he can kind of say, think in his own twisted mind that I am the Top Man, so can't be all bad, right? Probably the most ridiculous of all Mega Man bosses, at least up to this point. And by the way, you may have noticed, or at least you will notice by the end of this, that this Mega Man has the best music of all Mega Mans, which is what makes it one of many things that makes it the best. And pretty much every theme song, like traditional theme song, you have like the opening theme, and you have the boss select screen, and the weapon get screen. All of those themes are way better in this game than they are in all the other games. Hands down. Except for, like, some of the Wily stage themes aren't as good as the other ones, I'll admit that. And that's okay. They make up for it in other ways. considering the fact that this game is fucking long as shit compared to other games. I mean, maybe this started so many trends that other Mega Man games afterward kind of took as canon and standardized it. Like, for one, you have the rush weapons. Because, like, before this, remember Mega Man 2 had items 1, 2, and 3 just unlocked, and they would help you move around better. Like, the platform thing, and the jet conveyor thing, whatever. And that's fine. I mean, don't just call it item 1, 2, and 3, whatever. Doesn't matter, I guess. We won't care. We won't make fun of it in the future. But in this game, they say, hey, let's do pretty much the same thing. Improve the functions of the items. But let's actually turn it into an object. Something that has a name and makes sense. So then we have Rush, the robot dog. Because everyone wants a robot dog as a pet. It's the best pet ever thought of. And that's why Mega Man is cool. Because amongst all the other things he can do, he can jump and he can shoot and he can fight badass robots. And he can take their powers. He has a robot dog. And that wins 100% of the time. So now, this is about the halfway point of the stage. And I'm fighting more giant fucking reptile heads that blow up, and it'd be more interesting in that fight if, like, you were forced to actually use the little moving platforms in the middle to fight them. But no, that'd be a little too complicated, I guess. And I hate these pole vaulters where you can't shoot them until they drop their weapon. What the fuck's on the bottom of that pole vaulting thing that I can't shoot? It always bothered me. And now I'm outside for some reason. And, by the way, here's a pro tip. If you're playing this game, don't just stand there while the cloud rises to the top and touches you. You have to jump and land on it. Because, this game is kind of glitchy with clipping like that. So you won't just clip on top of it and be pushed up like you'd expect with normal physics. You'll get clipped all the way across the fucking screen and knocked off into death. Which wouldn't be so bad if this was Mega Man X, because you could just jump on the wall and you'd be back to normal and no harm done. But no, it's just instant death. So keep that in mind. Now we're getting to the boss. It's fucking Reptile. Basically, he's like Reptile from Mortal Kombat, except he can't turn invisible. And he's also kind of slow. But he just runs around like a boss and shoots snakes, which, I mean, Snake Man is pretty cool and all. Like, he can just shoot fucking snakes, and that's awesome. Just robot snakes that just eat everything. But, why exactly his Snake Man exist? Apparently, I don't know if you guys know this, but I heard that all the robots from Mega Man, from the Mega Man series, after, like, the first one, which the first one, they're all pretty simple and kind of obvious. Like, hey, let's make a guy that shoots fire. Let's make a guy that shoots ice. Let's make a guy that shoots lightning. And let's make a guy that shoots bombs. Okay, fair enough. But apparently, after that, they started taking fan submissions. Fans would just design their own fucking robots and send them into Capcom, and they'd use them. Which is pretty awesome. But some of these guys don't make any fucking sense, and now they're in the canon. But, they're still cool. I mean, Snake Man's cool. Shadow Man's pretty awesome. Fucking Sasuke Man. Dreidel Man is not so cool. But, you know, it's hit and miss. You take what you get. Still got a pretty cool stage. And here comes the introduction of a new character. The best Mega Man character, Proto Man. But I don't remember if this is supposed to be Proto Man or not. But right off the bat, the idea is that you don't know what the fuck this guy's motivation is. He comes in and he just wants to fucking shoot your face off. And you kick his ass and he runs away. So you come back later and he's totally gonna help you. And so you don't know what this guy's thinking. Or if it's just one guy. Maybe there's an imposter. an imposter for a guy you've never met. How do you know which one's real? Who's doing the impersonating? So this black and white, this isn't like this darkness and light. It is in some other stages, I can't think of offhand. I made it way harder than this. That's cool. It's cool that it's not so hard, but whatever. Actually, I think it might have just been in this game. You come back later and you gotta do platforms, which you're probably gonna skip because I don't wanna fuck up. Ruin my life. And now there's some kick-ass paratroopers, which fucking pissed you off if you didn't know they was there the first time. He's like skipping around like, oh, I'm doing cool. I'm jumping around, having fun. These platforms, no problem. And if like a paratrooper comes down and knocks you out of the sky and you're dead because you're falling in lava. But I do like they pop down and their eyes almost pop out of the head right before they hit the drawstring to save their life in the parachute. Like, oh shit, I almost killed myself. That would have been devastating. I got a wife and kids at home. That would have been no good. But then, you know, they're still going to die anyway because they realize, oh wait, that guy has a gun. And I totally have no weapons whatsoever. Why did they put me here? I'm just a kamikaze. Not even a good one. So this is like the hardest boss in all of Mega Man 3. And he gets beaten by the stupidest fucking weapon that Capcom has ever designed. And you can actually run out before you kill him. Which sucks, because then you gotta fight him. And he's not easy to fight. He's just jumping around like fucking jumping bean, throwing blades everywhere. Which I actually should have killed. I probably should have killed him second instead of going to fight Reptile, because that would have made Reptile's stage a lot easier. But whatever, it don't matter. I'm cool. But I need to kill him so I can get the Marine attachment, so I can get through one of the parts in this stage a lot easier. And get a bunch of E-tanks and all the crazy shit. And life ups. The hardest part about this stage is right here in the fucking beginning. There's all these fire dropping things, and I'm sure I could probably take them out with that Shadow Blade I just picked up, but I'm stupid. I'm lazy. I don't give a shit. I'm just gonna keep running. Hope I don't fall into a pit and die. But Gemini Man is kind of mysterious. Because what the fuck is a... What is a Gemini supposed to be? Is that really like the name of a crystal or something? Or an object? Like, I know it's like a constellation. But he's totally not a constellation. He's just a guy shooting lasers. With an evil twin brother. And hey, look, Proto Man's back. And he totally blows up this thing so I can progress. And he doesn't want to fight. So what is your motivation, Mr. Proto Man? Oh wait, I don't know his name's Proto Man yet. Or do I? They might have spoiled it on the box, I don't remember. I think it was just like, oh, it's an unknown robot. What's Mega Man gonna do? You know, or what are you gonna do? You don't know what's happening. Proto Man's most awesome character. Pretty sure we won't be seeing the last of him. But I think they got it wrong in the cartoon. I watched the cartoon, it was pretty good. And, like, he had a clear, objective in the Mega Man cartoon, which is completely opposite of what he had in this series. Like, he didn't want to kill Mega Man. He just wanted to, like, I don't know, prevent injustice, but he didn't want to be, like, a designated good guy. He was, like, a loner. So he was, like, an anti-hero or something. But in the Mega Man cartoon, all he wants to do is kill Mega Man. And he don't care whose side he's on that he has to do it. So he joins up with Wily. But Proto Man has never been on Wily's side in the games. I guess some creative liberties were taken. I mean, they did take Roll and turned her from a shitty little sister house cleaning robot and turned her into a badass kung fu rip your balls off character who was still fairly worthless in the grand scheme of things. And Mega Man is such a woman hater, misogynist character. He's just like, Nah, sit home. Your ass belongs in the kitchen. So, you know, they're still kind of enforcing stereotypes, but at least they were trying to combat them, I guess. I don't know if that's better or worse, and if they just left it how it originally was, or rolled as just a little fucking housekeeping robot in an apron. Like, I don't want to do anything. I'm just gonna do the dishes. I'm fine. You go out and have an adventure. I don't know if that's worse, or the fact that she's always going out to fight, and she's always either getting told to stay in her place, or just fucking up everything. But I don't think there was ever a situation, if you think that would lead, the obvious place that would lead is to, like, a hostage situation, where she'd be like, you know, she'd get captured, and then Mega Man has to, like, you know, fuck people for money or something to get her out of jail, or captivity. Oh, he's dead already. I didn't even get to commentate on it. Fucking snakes beat crystals, apparently. Or if you see a guy with an evil twin brother, just bring out a robotic snake and I'll fucking take him care of his ass, no problem. Now, this weapon's pretty cool, the Gemini laser. But it's actually pretty fucking worthless. Because, like, the beauty of Mega Man's abilities is that he can rapid fire shit. So he pulls out a weapon and just starts shooting it like crazy. And, you know, eventually he's gonna hit the guy and he'll be dead. But, no. That's not how this thing works. You can only shoot one at a time and it bounces off all the walls. So if you miss, you gotta sit there and wait for like 20 minutes until the thing disappears before you can shoot again. And the hardest part about Mega Man is it's not killing things, it's dodging things. So, it's the hard part. Never want to use this weapon again, just because of that. Only use it against bosses that it's really good against. Which is why I'm here, to fight Needle Man. Who's probably one of the badassest robots in this game. Because you can see the obvious applications for this guy. You know, he kind of fights like, sort of like Metal Man meets Quick Man. Just running around stabbing you in the face. You don't give a fuck. Shooting needles everywhere. He's an obvious fighting robot. Unlike fucking Top Man and, I don't know, Snake Man. I mean, Snake Man's only real weapon is to fucking run and tackle you with his face. Not a great defensive maneuver. I hate these needles. I can never figure out the timing. But it's okay. It's not instant death. I'm gonna try to kill this guy. Because I hate these fucking guys. This guy's gonna be a pain in the ass, isn't he? I'm almost dead. I'm gonna fucking die from this asshole. Just want this fucking E-Tank. I'm probably not even gonna fucking use it. But I want it, because it's right there. And I'm gonna fucking get it. You're not gonna stop me from getting it. Which, I love Rush. Rush is awesome. But, you would think at some point, maybe it happened, maybe we just don't remember it, but you would think Mega Man would get, like, some kind of, I don't know, lawsuit or something from PETA for pouncing on his robot dog to get hard-to-reach locations. At least that's the obvious thing I would think of, you know. That's not the right weapon, is it? Oh. Pull out this thing. This should work. I don't want it. Alright. So, I'm gonna be fighting Needle Man, and Needle Man isn't really that difficult, but I'm probably gonna get hit more than once, and he's gonna kill me in one shot with that much life, because he's a fucking boss. So, I'm just gonna totally stand right here, take one for the team. Yep. I got plenty of lives, it's cool. That'll probably never happen again. Come at me, bro. Gonna hit him. 3. There you go. Really hard. But it's still easier than fucking Mega Man 2. Or harder than Mega Man 2. Because Mega Man 2, at least, like, enemies are dying in 2 or 3 shots. Ooh. But in this game, they take at least, like, 4. So it's marginal improvement, but it's an improvement. And even without the weapon, some of them are kind of hard. Like, Shadow Man. Because you just got to sit there and hug him to death, and sometimes he doesn't want to be hugged.